Hey guys, Jabor Krip here, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Juventus career mode, where last time I thought I picked up three huge league wins in the league, including a win over AC Milan that put me 11 points clear. As you can see, I'm now about to play my last three. In this episode, I have three more league games, and then I'll be into the January transfer window. First up is Fiorentina. I also have games against Carpi and Lazio. So, some big games. Have reduced the gap to 5 points because they have played two extra games. So I have two games in hand, but they are back to 5 points. So if you see the, table in a minute, don't act surprised when you see that that the gap has been cut. I didn't play any extra league games that you guys missed that I lost. No, I still play. This is match number 15, and it's where you lost, where we left off from the last episode. The only match that did take place was I simmed the last Champions League game, group game against Man City, which I lost 2-0. Because I'm amazing. I didn't play it, I just simmed it. Yeah. Milan have played two extra games, that's why the gap is temporarily back to 5 points. I say temporarily because we both know. As soon as he played those two games in hand, I think one of them is this game. I'm assuming the others are the Carpi game or the game against Lazio, but we'll see. Yeah. Anyway, I wanted to talk to you guys about who do you think I should be signing, because in the transfer window, I have two positions I want to sign. I want to sign a right midfielder. Now, I'm torn where to go for someone to be a backup to Juan Cuadrado, who can play whenever Cuadrado gets injured, and keep Cuadrado, or send Cuadrado back to Chelsea and sign someone on a more permanent basis who won't get injured as much, because so far Cuadrado has gotten injured twice. He got injured again in the last episode, in case, just so you guys don't, in case you guys have forgotten now or you missed the last episode.
Score goals by just flicking a switch, it seems.
Cuadrado picked up another injury. He is recuperating. I did get the email that's, pops up when a player returns from injury, but I don't know if I want to bring him back, because I brought him back. He has one or two decent performances, and then he's injured again. And I'm like, if he's going to get injured after, two games, after every two games that he plays, what's the freaking point? I should just get a player who's not going to keep getting injured. So, I have looked at some options, but I would love your guys' feedback. Right midfielder, and I'm going to be signing a central player, a central midfielder. I have nothing against Sami Khedira, it's just I don't like playing with a center defensive mid. Even in my Liverpool career mode, I'm not really a big fan of it, and I've been thinking about changing Tielemans and Henderson to just a central mid and play a more 4-3-1-2 formation with wide players, and the center defensive mid, just the diamond formation of the 4-1-2-1-2, just with the CDM pushed down into a regular CM. I would much rather play a flat 4-3-3 in this career mode than play with a center defensive mid, which I'm not comfortable with. And I mean, I don't have a problem playing with it. It's not my kind of thing. I don't really play with center defensive mids. That's It's a position I find there's not enough, there's not a lot of players, there's not a lot of options for. Like, I mean, if there were more options, if there were more good options, I think I would look into it more, but I don't think so. I do see either as a point, you know, extra defensive power, but I think my defense is good enough not to need a center defensive mid, you know, backing them up. I think, you know, I've not conceded a goal in the league yet, and hopefully that will continue for another while. Maybe I'll end in this episode, I don't know.
This is like a kid in the
who you're watching.
He's never changed. He just
in my live game. Play is not pre recorded. Well, it is pre recorded when you see. You know, it's a bit hard to explain. It is pre-recorded because it's not recorded on the day it goes up, so to speak. But it's live when I play it. Yeah, it's very, you know. Rata! And wow. See, that's another reason why I want to bring in a right midfielder, because I want to put Anderson back on the left and just drop Morata to the bench and use him as an impact sub if need be, or maybe in cup competitions. But
Gonzalo Rodriguez, that's the referee's decision.
Yeah,
two added minutes.
It's not exactly going according to plan for Morata at the club so far. Khedira almost scored. He scored in two of the games in the last episode. You did miss the last episode. He scored against both Milan and against Empoli. He just failed to score against
Morata.
Oh, that's Palmeiro.
We're still waiting for that first goal.
So there is that. Yeah, and Milan are not playing. So this is. So I'm just going to assume this is one of my games in hand.
Whether we're going to finish the match as we start the second half.
That's good. Get the points back to where it should be, which is 11 points. I don't know why AC Milan had two games. We're given two games in hand. Now I have the two games in hand. I don't know. I don't know why they played two games before the rest of us. But, hey.
What you do when you get the ball,
two games less that they get to play, and once they are in need of points to catch me, I will definitely be thankful for that. At those two games that they played sooner than the rest of us.
And you'll be able to see on
here's the confirmation of my next game against Carpi.
Attacking now, Juventus.
Interesting, Morata. Pogba. Anderson.
What a fine save.
Pogba.
Marcos Alonso. A succession of corners here. What about Fiorentina's next game?
Well, the playing Chiesa, I think if I don't get a goal from this transition, I think a substitution might be needed. Let's see. Yeah, bring off Morata and bring on. Gonna bring on Baluli. Let's give Mario Mandzukic a chance. He did score a goal, really a crucial opponents. Goal at one point a few episodes ago when I did promise him a starting place if he did that, and I never gave him that start role. Also, maybe if he impresses in this game, I will definitely start him against Carpi. On my honor.
Marcos Alonso. Referee's given Fiorentina the free kick.
And impress doesn't exactly mean he has to score, I mean an assist. Just if it's for a crucial goal. Well, I will definitely consider an assist impressive. Mandzukic. Although a goal will go a very long way too. Mandzukic, he might get that assist. Oh, they just put the tackle in at the right time. Fiorentina Anderson
had a fine game, but now they're just going to just try and see it out, I think.
It's going to be a question of attack against defense, I think. Everybody behind
Sandro
trying to hold on to this position.
Kadira! Oh, Sammy Kadira!
Rodriguez. Marcos Alonso. Rossi. They're not satisfied, Fiorentina.
Oh, wow, that's going to be a foul there by Belouli. Yeah, of course, the idiot referee waited until I kicked the ball away. In real life, that would be a yellow card, but that stuff is not given in FIFA. At least I've never seen it. A yellow card given for that particular offense.
Through clever reading of the game.
In FIFA, maybe you guys have.
His team.
Yes, Pogba, now. Come on.
Would have been a crunching tackle if he'd felt.
Come on, Paul.
Out of the way of it.
Tuliso. Off the bar! The French connection almost got the goal. It's off the bar, Tuliso. No! That was the moment.
And on the clock, 8 more minutes. That's across the field to try and switch the play.
I don't think I'm going to get the 3 points in this one. I think this is going to be a draw. This is not good. I'm going to lose 2 of my points to the gap over Milan. I knew Fiorentina would be tough. Come on, Belouli, if we can get there. Put Rodriguez under pressure.
We've got 2 added minutes. That's been signaled now.
Mandzukic, come on.
Well, that's a good challenge between the two of them there.
Malo.
Opportunity now.
No! It's still there. It's still there. It's still there. Belouli. Whip it in.
And the cross comes in now. And the defender has blocked the cross.
Malo.
Well, it didn't quite cause the problems that it looked as though it would that cross.
Don't blow the whistle.
Now the defending team can play their way out of trouble.
Mandzukic! No! Mario! And there it is. I've dropped 2 points. No!
Really bad weather today. Really good game.
Oh, I can only put it to 9. No!
Entertaining. Great stuff.
My first dropped points of the season. Why are you celebrating, Pogba? This is bad.
They could have lost it, you know. They're expected to win every game.
On the home too. Look at that. 8 shots on target. Wow. No one was clinical enough. 5.4. Yeah, that's not impressive at all, Mandzukic. Oh, I can't believe this is not a good start.
Serie A. Chievo Verona 2 at Atlanta 0.
Let's just put that behind me and
nil.
Try and concentrate on getting 3 points in my next game.
Napoli 1
against Carpi
2. Now let's see what effect that's had on the standings. At the top of the table remains.
It's gonna annoy me now for a while.
In second, AC Milan.
Hate dropping points. Where are Fiorentina in the league? 11th. With 28 points.
In fourth,
I mean, if it were Lazio, I don't think I would have been too upset because they're fifth.
Lazio with 27 points. In sixth, Chievo Verona with 26 points.
In over seventh, 2 Palermo precious points.
In eighth, Genoa with 21 points.
I may as well have not beaten Milan now for all the good that I did in this episode.
Bottom, Sampdoria with 12 points. Fourth bottom, Bologna with 15.
Evra's retiring, so I don't think I can sign him to a new contract. They're bored, so sorry. I was gonna offer him a new contract, but he didn't want one. I think he has his heart set on retiring. Sandro is playing anyway, and he's playing fantastically, so. Oh, I still can't believe that happened.
Hi there, everybody. I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith has joined me for this Serie
A. I got a nice early goal here against Carpi, just to make me feel better about that game. Go on, Anderson. Straight away! He's caused a save anywhere, straight away. It's come to Khedira!
Oh, great work by the keeper. Goal kick to come.
And I can't keep it in, brilliant.
Key figure for Juventus in this fixture, I'm sure he's going to be.
What form he's showing in front of goal. Top scorer in the league with 18.
It's good work between these two.
Dybala.
Real good contest between these two as they...
He can hit it.
Dybala. Pogba. Yes.
Goal for Juventus.
9 minutes. That's exactly the response I was hoping for, or from you boys. Yes, good job, Pogba. Can't afford any more dropped points, so we're gonna put that Fiorentina draw behind us, and we're gonna give Carpi a slapping. Sorry, Carpi, he nothing personal. I'm just. You're the team I have to take out my frustration on, because you're the team I'm playing.
And they've got themselves to be top of the league by playing like this.
Yeah, they have. I mean, they've got some top players, haven't they? Let's face it, and they've shown that out there today. They've really played some good football.
And that will be a throw.
Yes, they've given it straight to Tolisso. Dybala is way out of position. And where was he going? Seriously.
Pass coming in midfield.
I mean, if he made the run or was in his position to begin with, oh my god, if that had gone in, I think I would have actually thrown my controller out my window. Just been like, nah.
Dybala.
Come on, Dybala. Come on.
The break is definitely on.
The goddamn legs off. Dybala! Straight at the goddamn keeper. Brilliant.
Not really what he wanted to do. Offside. That's an easy decision.
Let me play on. I had the ball. Idiot. Referee. Pogba, seriously. Pay attention, for fuck's sake.
Wallace.
Marta.
Trying to keep the ball, not anymore. They cope with it well.
It's out for a corner.
But he took no chances there.
I'll do. Leads to a goal anyway. Pogba, no. Of course, Pogba has to make a goddamn idiot of himself. Seriously, he's running. He almost looks like he's running away from the ball. Well, now, well, that's twice he's done that in quick succession in this match. Pogba.
Juventus regain possession here. That is a very good tackle to get the ball. Morata. Oh, in goes the cross.
Within. Yes, Dybala heads it in. 2-0. That is exactly the response we needed. It, no more of this nil-nil crap. That's what I needed. It from
just widen the margin here to
the players. The response of all responses is two goals. Was a nice dominating performance. Well, not dominating yet. It's getting there.
Work to do.
At least so.
Lost their last two games.
Could he get a goal? Oh no, but Anderson is getting a header that in, and it's 3-0.
Very good build up, Alan. Very good goal.
Well, you've got to ask questions
and
to the defense.
Suddenly,
because
it's
they
looking
just
very
didn't
good, isn't it?
I don't think we expected this. Such a one sided affair, but look at the scoreline.
Game to this point, 8 shots, 8 on target for Juventus.
There's been no wastage here, has there? Really good from this team.
Gabriel Silva.
Yeah, you know what? Play around with the ball, Carpi. That's not going to get you any goals.
No danger at all for the goalkeeper here or for the defending team. And they will play from the goalkeeper now. Morata.
Never mind, it's half time. 3-0 up.
And today it's carpet.
Looking pretty good. Milan are playing, so the Lazio game is the other game in half.
Just a change now. He's bringing on a new player.
Hopefully.
It's hard for a team with
Florin, whoever the fuck that is who's playing.
Second 45 minutes, but we'll see how this team does.
AC, maybe they'll draw with them and take 2 points off them.
Good distance to the clearance.
And my lead at the top of the table can be restored to what should be 11 points. A cross almost went in. It was way too close to the keeper, but he did have to. He had to hit it away.
Sami Khedira.
Nice try to Khedira to Pogba.
Oh, he slipped his man. And shoots!
And
good stop by the goalkeeper.
I don't know. I really don't.
I think that's a good performance, isn't it, Alan, from him in the first half?
I would be happy.
Dybala.
First 45 minutes. It was a good goal from him.
Another shot!
Oof. Just as they were talking about him being the
the ball escape his grasp.
Player to watch. Almost bagged a second goal. Which is almost a guarantee that he'll get a hat trick. Almost. It wasn't against Parma. Well, unfortunately, he only bagged 2 against his former club. Despite my attempts to get him a third.
And he's got past it. Start again with a goal kick. Different angle on the goal here.
Well, he's gone down the middle. Wasn't the most difficult header to save, but he scored in the end. Well done.
And the home side will be in action again.
Carpi have a game on the first.
On EA Sports in Serie A.
We don't have no game in between then and the first. Maybe they're one of the teams Milan played in their games in hand.
Have the ball. Sami Khedira. It's a quick break. And the referee blows his whistle. The flag was up for offside.
Oh, wait. I know now why Milan played 2 games in hand. They're not in the Champions League. That's why. All right.
Well, now they've won the ball back. In the middle of the park by intercepting that pass.
And the Champions League would probably affect the scheduling.
Straight at the goalkeeper.
I don't think they're in the Europa League either, so no European football for Milan to worry about.
Warming up for the home team. We'll see who comes on.
What to excite their fans with. Khedira! Straight to keeper.
Goalkeeper's midriff.
And this is why I'm looking at a central midfielder, plays in general. When Khedira is not quite as clinical as I would like him to be.
Next match, Alan.
Anderson.
In their next match in
Go on, get a nice cross in. Boom. It's Dybala with his second of the match.
The way he's moved on to that ball, you just knew he was going to score with that header. Really good take.
20th of the season. He's almost reached
really on their game today.
One more and he will have the same number of goals in the league as number on his shirt.
Can weigh heavily, expectation and all that.
That doesn't mean anything, but
no, I think their manager will be
symmetry. Yay!
Taken it easily at all. They've given.
Is that the right word? Yeah, it is.
But they've shown the class too.
Woo! Yeah, I'm freaking amazing. And you get the hat trick.
The break is definitely on.
Foul? The ball. No. Just. Yeah, muscle him off the ball, you know? That's Juventus. Yeah, that's totally fine. Shoulder bumping is one thing. But when you damn near manhandle someone off the goddamn ball, surely that's a foul.
Gabriel Silva.
And that's going to be a yellow card, because I'm brilliant.
Well, that incident's been assessed by the referee, and he's shown the yellow card to the Juventus man.
Did Anderson just flip off the referee?
That was an easy decision for the ref.
Well, it is.
Don't get yourself into more trouble, Philippe.
And the decision for the added time is 3 minutes. Chiellini. That will help ease the pressure.
See so.
Strong tackle to
taken away from him, and he's not. And we're not gonna see another hat trick from Dybala. It doesn't matter. I've beaten Carpi anyway. 4-0. Very comfortable. Ben Anderson getting goals as well. Oh, so all around a very solid offensive performance from the old lady. After a disappointing one.
Two. And let's take a look at what those results mean to the league table. At the top of the table remain Juventus with 46 points. In second, AC Milan with 40 points. In third, Roma with 28 points. In fourth, Napoli with 27 points. In fifth, Lazio with 27 points. In sixth, Chievo Verona with 26 points.
Carpi's manager impressed by
22 points.
Assistant.
Eighth, Genoa with 21 points. Bottom of the table, Frosinone with 10 points. And then reading up the table, second bottom, Sampdoria with 12
right,
points.
Okay. Fourth bottom,
Bologna with 15 points.
Anyway, Milan, they won. 16 points. Anderson back to play his former club just before the window where I will be adding more new players. I didn't mean for the Anderson-Malo duo signings to be improving my right-hand side. But that's how it worked out.
And their lineup for you now. Federico Marchetti starts in goal.
Last game before the window opens to me, and I can start working on getting those new signings in. I'm to see if I can get one in particular would be very interesting signing. You guys know I'm after Berardi.
His marker cleverly.
The only player I'm after. Penalty! Imagine. That was actually cute. It wouldn't be the only stupid penalty I've seen given today.
Asserting his authority here early on, giving that free kick.
And Alberto Moreno should consider himself a very lucky boy that
a team game, but
that particular mistake didn't cost Liverpool 20 points.
Oh, he's failed to hit the target.
Against Norwich in what was a tiring match to watch. So I can only imagine how it was to play in.
And in goes the cross, and he heads it for goal. What a good way to score.
Oh, and Anderson, a goal against his former club, ruled out for offside.
He looks back on that, I think he might be a bit disappointed because the striker seemed to time his run really well.
Abdoulaye Konko. This is the sort of side with the credentials to win the league, and they're getting themselves in a good position to do that.
They are. I mean, they've not been fazed at all by being top. Sometimes it can affect teams in a less
Pogba.
Positive way, but they look as if they're made for that top ranking.
Dybala.
Abdoulaye Konko. Sami Khedira.
Anderson to Morata. To Pogba. Very. This time. Yes. Second time I'm asking Paul Pogba. Opens the scoring.
It's a classy goal.
And it's 1-0. Seventh goal. Oh. He's starting to get that goal scoring form. I was hoping to see a good few goals from him this season, and that's why initially I wanted to play him at camp. Of course, as I said in the during the first match, I no longer have a desire to play him at camp. I'm much happier playing the 4-3-3, and I don't think I will be going back to the 4-1-2-1-2. Unless I use it for cup games with Mandzukic maybe playing with Morata.
Will be a throw. It's gone out of that player there.
Choice I just gave myself. And there's a cup game scheduled for January, so
good stop by the goalkeeper.
Could definitely see how that works out. It's good I can use it again.
Dybala.
Anderson scores against his former club. Denied earlier by the offside, not denied this time.
Well, he's hit it hard and he's hit it first time, but perhaps the keeper could have got more on that.
We can see a slightly different viewpoint on it.
Let's see what Kondreva.
Restarting at 2-0. Really trying to use the.
Good to see they use that money I gave them for Anderson wisely. I bet they wish they didn't take it now. Anderson has scored and Kondreva hasn't. Although they play two completely different sides of the pitch.
Stefan Radu. It's a decent cross.
They put that Keita.
Too close to the goalkeeper.
Who would they replace Anderson wins.
This is what it says on the board. Dybala.
The break is definitely on.
Khedira.
Nothing wrong with the shot, really, except the direction. It was hit well enough. The goalkeeper didn't have to move a muscle except to catch it.
Maybe if he was actually looking at the ball. Oh, I was expecting someone to be running in to hit that, and I was looking for Pogba, actually. It was actually Khedira who was my first player forward for some reason. Ah, well, it's 2-0. Well, I'm looking good to get 3 more points.
And the second half is underway. Antonio Candreva.
I didn't even check to see if Milan were playing. I'm just assuming that they're not.
Bilia.
That their next game isn't until January. Dybala. Dybala! He puts it over the bar. Did I chip it? I'm just wondering now, did I accidentally chip it? Because if I did, that's my complete accidental fault. But my fault nonetheless. Yeah, please book this guy now, ref. Ref? Thank you. Oh, it's Witzel. Did he play for Lazio in real life, or is that transferring the game? I could have sworn he still plays for Zenit in real life. Unless I'm mistaken.
He's made the save.
I didn't hear of him moving to Lazio in real life. Again, like I said, I don't really follow Italian football as much as I should. Is that it's Anderson again? He scored a brace against his former club, and Candreva is pissed. He's like, God damn it!
Header that is to find the top right.
Well, let's take another look at the goal.
Anderson with a beautiful header.
One team really on their game.
Second goal again.
The other very off.
And for him, third of the game for the team. And wow, they're just piling it on now, or let's see. Oh, they're giving it straight back to me.
Work on the ball.
To Liso. To Anderson for the hat-trick penalty. Yep. What a bunch of idiots. It's the captain. What has he done? He's given Radu. He's given Anderson the chance to, from the spot, complete a hat-trick against his former club. Sorry, Daba, but we have a hat-trick. Wow, 58. I'm going to have to be on the mark. Bang in the green. And yep, there's the hat-trick. Anderson is the third player to score a hat-trick, and for me, he as Juve manager, with the others being Dybala scoring multiple, and Cuadrado against Borussia Mönchengladbach, like a few episodes ago, and now, Anderson has joined that list with his hat-trick against his former club, against Lazio, to complete the demolition and secure that I'm going to win this game very comfortably.
The goalkeeper with a textbook save and keeps the ball in his grasp. And the home side will be in action again, and you will be able to see it on EA Sports in Serie A.
If you look at the coaching manual, you don't defend like that.
He's foul.
Two
shots on here. Great work by the goalkeeper. The ball is his, and he's made sure he's protected it. Trying to widen the approach play here, but it's out for...
A header didn't go as planned. Anderson is hunting the shit out of this side of the pitch. They're probably sick to death of him now.
Closer. And the cross coming in.
Good defensive header there by Sandro. Played a nice ball to Dybala.
This is how they love to play on the break.
That's a foul, thank you very much.
Options for him from the free kick, whether to go for goal or put it to where his teammates
are lining up. 33.
Well, the threat was there. Wasn't quite the goal.
Not
keeper might have been relieved there, Martin, because
not a million miles away. No, it's not my worst free kick. It's not my best by any stretch of the imagination. But I've hit worse, so there's that. It's sort of an improvement. I wouldn't go worrying home about it though.
Chiellini.
It's
closer.
Going home with all 3 points, will Juve.
Morata.
Can we get one more goal? Morata. Play through the Dybala for the 21st goal. Oh. Nope, and we're offside anyway, so it wouldn't have mattered. Wow, that was way wider than the mark there, Buffon.
Stefan Radu.
You're a legend, so you get a pass.
Real good contest between these two as they jostle for possession. Sami Khedira.
Almost time up.
Axel Witsel.
Referee will probably blow the whistle any moment now. There it is. He's put Lazio out of their collective misery.
By the final whistle, 4-0.
Anderson will collect.
It was absolutely extraordinary.
The match ball.
Elegant, excellent.
Scoring the hat trick against his former club.
From the ref, a hat trick, and that's to be
4-0 against Lazio. Pretty good. Really, he scored 4 goals if you include the offside one. So, yeah, and a 9.2. Very good performance. And Milan did not play. So that was my second game in hand. So,
Serie A.
Yeah, the gap is 9. It will be. I will restore that gap. Don't worry about it.
At the top of the table remain Juventus with
49. It's only a temporary setback.
AC Milan.
Once I bring in my new recruits in the January transfer window. Oh,
Napoli with 27 points. In 5th, Lazio with 27.
I don't think there will be anyone who will oppose me. I mean, look at the gap between Milan and Roma. It's almost a two-horse
bottom of the table, Frosinone.
Horse race already. Third bottom, Sampdoria. Here with Roma on 29 to 40. That's 11 points. So anyway, off camera, I will start my pursuit of my players. If you have any suggestions in the comment section below, please leave them. But until next time, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Hit smash the like button if you did. Subscribe for more. And until next time, have a very nice day.